Vivekananda Vedanta Society of Chicago invites all to attend Society's special standout program in the same event on Friday the 18th of August from 1 p.m. Central Standard Time to 2:30 p.m. Central Standard Time at room E353B at McCormick Place. The program name is A Call to Conscience, Defending Freedom and Human Rights. Swami Balabhadrananda, AGS of Ramkrishna Mission, Velar Math, India, will deliver speech. Swami Sarvapriyananda will give the Vedantic perspective of defending and human rights. Apart from that, Swami Kripamayananda will lecture on how a spiritual practices can help us defending freedom and human rights. Swami Tyagananda will discuss on the same topic in the light of Sri Ramkrishna. Obviously, our beloved Swami Ishatmananda will be the host and anchor this program. But the center of attraction is going to be Swami Sarvapriyananda, who is a prominent spiritual teacher and monk in the Ramakrishna Order of India.
Here is my humble effort to put some points on the same topic, defending freedom and human rights. We are excited to listen from all Swamiji from Ramakrishna Mission on the 18th of August, 2023 at McCormick Place. Stay tuned.
While Swami Vivekananda's teachings often centered on spirituality, self-realization, and personal development, he also expressed thoughts related to freedom and human rights in the context of a broader social and philosophical framework. Here's a perspective that could be associated with defending freedom and human rights, drawing from his teachings. Swami Vivekananda emphasized the inherent divinity within every individual. He believed that recognizing the divinity within oneself and others is essential for promoting a just and harmonious society. In this context, defending freedom and human rights could be understood as a means to allow every individual to realize their potential and express their innate divinity without hindrance. Vivekananda's ideas on self-realization and freedom can be linked to defending human rights in the following ways. Dignity and equality. Vivekananda stressed the importance of recognizing the intrinsic worth of every individual. Upholding human rights means treating all individuals with dignity and respect, regardless of their background, caste, gender, or social status. This aligns with his teachings about seeing the divine essence in everyone. Empowerment. Swami Vivekananda believed that education and empowerment were essential for personal growth and societal progress. Defending human rights involves ensuring that everyone has access to education, opportunities, and resources, enabling them to realize their potential and contribute to society. Freedom of thought. Vivekananda championed the freedom of thought and expression. He believed that every person should have the liberty to explore and express their ideas, as long as it doesn't infringe upon the rights of others. This aligns with the principles of freedom of speech and expression that are fundamental to human rights. Social justice. Vivekananda emphasized the need to address social inequalities and alleviate the suffering of the less fortunate. Defending human rights involves working towards social justice, equality, and the elimination of oppression and discrimination. Spiritual democracy. Vivekananda envisioned a spiritual democracy where individuals were free to choose their paths of self-discovery. In a similar vein, defending human rights includes ensuring that individuals have the freedom to practice their chosen religion, belief system, or philosophy without coercion.
While Swami Vivekananda didn't explicitly formulate a comprehensive doctrine on defending human rights, his teachings indirectly support the values of individual dignity, empowerment, freedom, and equality, all of which are essential components of human rights advocacy. Thank you for watching and supporting my channel. Stay tuned.